Alright guys, welcome back to the Road to Supersonic Legend series. We're on episode number 13, and last episode I revealed quite a big strategy that you guys can use to improve your game. And we're currently sitting at Gold 2, Division 2, I believe. And this is currently the average rank of Rocket League, I would say, which is really, really good. We're going to be starting to move up the ranks pretty fast here. I want to be talking a little bit more about that strategy we talked about on the last episode, but if you want to go watch that episode, I definitely highly recommend it. But let's jump into the first games here and see how they go. Before we get into the series, I'd like to thank the sponsor for today's video, Raycon. Raycon earbuds start at about half the price of any other premium wireless earbuds out there right now. They're discreet, lightweight, and sound just as amazing as any of the other top brands. They're great for exercising, working from home, and just about anything you can think of. Their everyday E25 earbuds are the ones that I have, and they're the best model so far. They come with 6 hours of battery life, seamless Bluetooth pairing, and compact design that has a nice noise isolating fit. I personally have the red pair, and I really like that they stay put in my ears while running, and I appreciate the range of sizes available. These would make a great gift this holiday season, and a gift that you can give that they'll use every day. There are plenty of colors and fits to choose from, and they come with a nice charging case as well. The case can charge the earbuds up to 4 times on a single charge. I really like these earbuds, and I think you guys would enjoy them as well. And now is the time to get the best prices of the year on the Raycon earbuds, but make sure you act now, because this offer is only available for a limited time. Be sure to click the link in the description, or go to buyraycon.com/lethamyr for 20% off of your purchase. That's buyraycon.com/lethamyr for 20% off. A big thanks once again to Raycon for supporting the channel. Now let's get into the series. Hope you guys enjoy. All right, we got Chronos Junkie, James, and Kamikaze. Quite the names we got here. So as I talked about before, we've got that we're a little bit higher up in the ranks now, which means we can actually start to make some good approaches, see if people have good defense and clear the corners and stuff. As we move up through these episodes, the gameplay is gonna move faster and faster, and hopefully at some point your rank will be kind of reflected on what players you see in the game. Like, you kind of know, oh, this is the rank I'm at. I can maybe learn from these games. And that's hopefully the strategy of this series of videos, is that no matter what rank you are, you'll see your gameplay at some point. Right here, the guy should have challenged that. She should have pushed out. Let's wait behind Kamikaze here. Good clear. So I'm gonna loop wide here. Good demo as well. Up over the one, making a pretty good challenge there. So we're getting into players who are making good challenges. Good chance, and they own gold. Very nice. So that's a good touch by Kamikaze. I didn't mention at the start, but our name is I Actually Can't Score. We've got the Glizzy Gobbler himself, Sizz, as you can see in the photo there. I hope you guys think I picked a good photo. I thought it was a funny cartoon image there. But yeah, if you want to be part of the next episode, thanks to Thomas L for that recommendation, by the way. Just comment what you think the name and picture should be. That's a good clear from them. Should be a goal too. Definitely could have beat him there if I wasn't autopiloting, but in that situation, either I want to rush that immediately or back off, because the clear is not that dangerous. You can see it bounces quite a few times here. If I just moved back and collected that ball as I usually do, it would have been a free touch to make another play on their side. So we're 1-1 so far. That's good. So the guy's staying relevant on the ball. This guy wants to go for the mid boost. I see that, so I'm going to move behind him. I make sure to touch that. My teammate is in the way, which is fine. He says sorry, so he realizes it. He's very chasey. I can tell that he wants to turn on the ball every single time, which is fine. I'm just going to let him do that, as I talked about before. It's a good pass. So here I'm going to clear it nice and high. See how much power you get with a high loft. Add some pressure. It's good. Still pretty dangerous though. All right, teammate needs to just fully rotate. He needs to finish that rotation. If he doesn't though, just realize that and make sure you let him do what he's doing and don't overcommit with him, because what you might normally do might not be what you want to do. Like, this touch isn't really necessary, but I'll bring it over to the wall. I'll pop it out real quick. He's up for it. That's fine. Make a quick shot to the far side. And there we go. We got a goal. So because I was patient and waited in midfield there for the shot to come in, and Chronos makes a really bad touch off the corner, I can come in and just shoot that ball and wait for that ball to come to me instead of trying to force myself into a position where I don't need to be. And I don't want to be uncomfortable, right? So teammate says take the shot. I'm in the position to take the shot, obviously. So I will take the shot. Bit of a miss from him. Could be a shot opportunity. Bit of a miss. So see here when the ball's really high, I want to loop wide first. Could be a good dunk from them. Almost a shot. The reason why I loop wide there is to give myself more room to make the pressure. All right. Yeah, take over, man. It's all good. There we go. Just make, once again, just high clears like this. Just throws people off in the midfield at this level. Once again, just high pops. Probably not in a very comfortable position. Teammate makes a shot towards net, and it's in. So I'm not doing too much work there. I'm just making a few touches to pop it up really, really high. And it gives us a good advantage. And then Kamikaze can come in and finish it off. It's a nice one. So pretty good so far. Like I said, this is the average rank of Rocket League right now. So if you want to be above average or more than average, just those positionings. And like I said, I'll reflect on the red light, green light strategy we talked about before. Just once again, I don't think this is a comfortable position to challenge. Still isn't. Now I can come in because that player left the ball. So I just think about that all the time. Okay. All right. All right, teammate. That's a good flick. I probably a little bit too advanced, but what I do there is I drive away from the ball for a second to the right and then flick it to the left. And that gives that extra power. But that's a little more advanced. If you want to look into those flick mechanics, you can look up tutorials on how to do those kind of things. But for now, I need to slow it down because that's a bit too much. Right here, the ball's not going to be dangerous if it rolls off the wall. I can stay near it. And right here, I can force 50-50 in a position where my teammate can follow it up. So I just sit behind the ball and let the opponent make the touch. And even here, I just fake that because it's not dangerous unless I go. It's only dangerous if I commit. So even right here, I can wait behind my teammate. He's going to chill with it. Okay. Well, I thought he was going to touch it. That's okay, though. Still okay. My teammate is literally on my bum. And it's a goal because of it. So hopefully he learns for next time not to just sit on my car. And yeah, like he doesn't even see that I exist. He's just completely ignoring me. Which is interesting. It's like I'm invisible or something. That's like complete tunnel vision. When players get like that, you gotta be a little bit careful. Like, honestly, I was debating just literally driving out of the way to like not even be on the ball anymore because I just didn't want that to happen to me. But this guy does not get off the ball. So we'll be the bigger person and let him just do whatever he wants to do. And this is what I was talking about. Don't be too stressed out about players, you know, all over the ball like this. Just wait. Just wait for them. Don't be jumping into every ball. Right here, I have some space to turn. Let him touch the ball. It's fine. Let him touch the ball. It's all good. Like I said, a lot of the times, a player touching the ball isn't that dangerous. As long as you react in time. So just wait for them to make the mistakes. Take a touch in the corner. See if my teammate wants to push in. It's a good challenge. Could be a shot here too. It's a good pass. I will finish that. It's a little bit faster, but you can see I'm ready for it. I can see that's going to happen earlier, so I end up positioning wider. I do a wide loop to get ready for that, and that's why I'm in that position. If I got there faster, I would have had no momentum and probably not been able to react in time and make the shot. So making sure I'm sort of posturing that midfield and just staying ready and available for anything that's going to happen. I see that the guy went for the back corner boost, so I have some space to sit on this. Teammate's zero boost and wants to challenge. It's fine once again. Don't need to worry about that. Let's see what he does here. Rotation's a little bit rough. Now he gets boost. Because he was up there for so long with zero boost, he's not able to support me because he wasn't getting pads and stuff. Once again, just put positioning to make them do something and then backing off. That's okay. Just waiting for them once again. Sometimes waiting for the last, very, very last second. When you have control of the ball and you have the last second opportunity... This guy, man. When you have the last second chance to shoot it over them, it's going to be a lot better for you if you make them fully commit. So holding on to the ball until they're near the challenge, if you have control, is very, very good strategy to throw people out of the game, very, very far out of the game to get a lot more time, you know, in a 2v1 situation or even a 1v1 situation if you make someone fly off the ball like that. So we divvied up to Division 3, Gold 2, Division 3, not too bad. We'll be moving into Gold 3 probably in this video, hopefully. Let's see how the next game goes. All right, we got some more. Oh, actually, we actually got PC players, or yeah, PC players this time. That's like the first time in the super long. Once again, I'm just gonna wait for this ball to roll down the wall and take control. And here I have space on the wall. They're last, so I just wanna make a challenge. Obviously, if I was a higher level player, I would make a faster challenge there and just pop it over them. But I'm trying to play at the pace of a gold player. I've been hearing from you guys in the comments that you guys do go for aerials quite a bit in gold. So I'm trying to mimic that a little bit. I see that my teammate's going to pass that middle. I want to make sure I'm ready for it. Once again, I'm in front of my teammate, but he goes. A little bit dangerous. I need to be ready for that in the future. So let's see what happens here. Even though everybody missed, they still have the advantage. There's no reason to push into that. Pop it around one. And do a nice little flick. See my teammate can be ready for it. It's a good try. Oh, wait. I didn't want to shoot that strong. I could have just shot that top right, but I wanted to follow up the pass, but not make it strong. And then he ended up pre-jumping, I think, because I did a backflip shot. That's a good pass. So far, so good, though. I'm not really sure what that guy's name is, like Farron or something. Get the back corner boost. He threw the ball away. Right here, he's pretty close, but he's also zero boost. So I know I have space to just pop this up. One simple touch and then another follow-up. I'll pop this up into mid, see what happens. It's a good clear. I like how my teammate is positioning a lot better this game. He's positioning in midfield and getting ready for it. Bit of a miss there, but they're pretty close, and I don't want to do a last man 50-50 there. So we're going to back off and then make a shot towards target, and they end up missing. So I thought that was a little bit weak enough that they would actually make a clear, but it seems it was good enough, and he calls him noob. Oh, and so it begins. Let's see. what is going on in the chat? All right, let's see what the teammates got here. He could have waited for that. He didn't have to jump for it because now he's committed into the corner. Let's see if they make a save here. He's last, and he's the guy who called them a noob. It's a good save. So, I mean, you don't have to call him names or, you know, be mean to the guy. Right here, I can see that it's going to bounce out mid. I just pop it up. And they ended up missing both of them. So, let my teammate come in and finish that. And there we go. So, I technically didn't score that one. But I know we've scored twice this game. Just being ready on the positioning of the ball. And being ready for the next touch. If I loop wide and spend some time going onto defense, it's a lot better for you in the long run. As you can see, I'm getting a lot of collections of the ball when they throw the ball down to me. Instead of just hitting the ball as soon as possible, use the fact that you have space and time to get a better touch and move down the field. I always find it so funny how players in these ranks trash talk their teammates when you're all kind of not good at the game. I'm gonna be real with you. You know, you're not great at the game. You need a lot more practice. I talked about this with SunlessCon the other night. That when I practiced, like when I started off this game, I'd sit in training for 5-6 hours at a time and practice my mechanics over and over and over again until I got very comfortable with it. And I don't think a lot of people invest a lot of time. You know, if you really think that you've spent enough time, you need to reevaluate how much time people have invested at the pro level. I've got 11,000 hours in this game, and that's not even including my alt accounts. So yeah, it's a lot of time. See, my teammate finishes it off. Nice try. Popped it around mid. Right here, I'm just going to pop it up high. Cause some pressure. Right here, I see that I have some space. This is what I'm talking about, like where I loop wide. My teammate does get the ball, but it's still good for me to let that ball give me some space to play with. I see no one's challenging me in the corner, so I'm going to pop it over one. A little bit rough. Nice try, though. I see that I can get possession of that ball first. I don't want to challenge this yet. My teammate's landing really, really slowly. My decision making is all based on the position of my teammate as well. So I'm going to bring this over here. A little bit of a bump. That's okay, though. And you can see how even though my teammate took that corner boost, I'm okay because I've been conserving my boost. It's a good challenge. Staying close. It's a good try. Once again, my teammate's pretty far away, so I'm going to wait for a shot first. That's why I can get in this position to defend well. This ball rolls up the wall for me, so I can clear it out. Teammate is trying to go for that corner boost, so I'll stay with this. Should be okay. But yeah, back onto the whole concept. It'll take hundreds and hundreds and thousands of hours to get good at this game. It is one of those games where you just can't naturally pick it up and be like, oh, yeah, I know what I'm doing. Because it's like walking with your feet for the first time in your life. It's a whole new feeling. This game is pure physics-based. and there's nothing really more to it. You have to just put the time in to get used to the timing of everything. Think about the first time you kicked a soccer ball, how bad the kick was, and then how you learned to time it a little bit better. So I could try once again. Just trying to set up my teammate, but he's always like too far behind the play. And that's okay though, because I'm gonna just loop wide here and shoot it up high on target. Bit of a miss. So here is one of those situations where he could have brought that to the corner and got the boost. I ended up taking it because I saw him doing the play that he was doing. But if it's trying to like, you need to cut your losses. The ball's not in a scoreable position. So make sure you just loop it wide and, you know, make another possession. That's a good try. Almost a goal there. See if I can pop this middle for him. And there we go. Nice shot. So you know what? Don't get frustrated with your teammate. He may have missed a few nets where it definitely should have been a goal. But at the same time, you depend on him for this game when you're in here. And focus on yourself and how you should be playing. But, you know, learn how to play around people that play differently, because not everybody has the same brain. Not everybody plays the same way. Everyone's going to make mistakes in different spots. Part of the game is learning how to compensate for those mistakes. Playing perfectly doesn't always work in this game. So, actually, most of the time in high-level Rocket League, when you score, it's usually because you didn't play the position perfectly, because everyone's expecting the perfect play. Because at this point, everyone knows what everyone's like capable of doing. So it's a different situation. Hopefully my teammate doesn't touch that ball. I was kind of scared he was going to backflip into it. Right here, I can time that boom so that it goes up really, really high. And in this situation, I can just pop it up off the backboard and see if my teammate finishes it. Good try. Almost. There we go. Nice. Once again, just hitting my teammate from that backboard hit. It's good to challenge that, I think. My teammate was in a pretty precarious situation, though, if I got a bad 50-50. But I know myself that I can win those if I go fast enough. And as you play the game and you play with confidence and you don't hesitate, you'll know what and what not to go for. If you go in a situation where you're like, okay, that didn't work, then next time when you challenge that same situation, you can go, okay, maybe I shouldn't just barrel into this. Good save. It's a good play. See, my teammate brings it back. This is good. A little bit of lack of control, but that just comes with time of playing. But I like that he brought it back. It's a good clear to the corner. Being bumped, but it's okay. I'll go to the corner here. Just keep in possession. Ball bounces mid. It's a decent shot, but it'll be a good save to the corner. Spaz has possession here, so I don't want to fully challenge. Now I can, because he let go of the ball a little bit. It's good. A little bit dangerous. Here's where you want to learn how to jump out off the wall like this. Obviously, I didn't clear very well, but I'm not trying to make a perfect clear right now. I'm just trying to show you that that's what you should be jumping for. Are they in a real one over there? They are. Okay. So we're in a 1v1. Now this is a precarious situation because how do I score? I'm going to mess this up. I'll see if... oh, they didn't break. Well, I don't know if I just hold this for the last 10 seconds. I'm going to break this guy. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, well. That was interesting because I'm not supposed to score really that often, but I'm trying to follow the name, right? I actually can't score. But yeah, that was an interesting game. They got a rule one in the corner. We're moving up, though. Teammate is Division 3 or Gold 3, Division whatever. We're Division 4 now, so we're moving in pretty close to Gold 3 finally. But yeah, going back onto the whole thing about like when a noob calls another player a noob, I think that you just need to realize that everyone's still learning at this level. You're not an expert by any means. You don't really know the proper rotation and stuff. It just comes with time. And unless you have like, you know, if you have like 5,000 hours and you're in gold, you know, that happens. But you got to change how you're learning. Because if you're not moving in the game, if you're not improving, there's got to be a different way you got to play the game or think to be able to move up in the ranks. And hopefully by this series, by watching this series, you learn a few things about how to change your perspective and how to think. Because going gung-ho all the time isn't how Supersonic Legend players play. They have good mechanics, obviously, but you want to make sure that we play with strategy and you know, clear ideas of what we're doing. Every time I'm thinking about which boost pad I'm going to jump to and stuff, it's multitasking at its finest, basically. So there's two players in the corner. So I have a chance. See if my teammate can clear down the field. It's a good touch. I'll let him go since I'm in front of him, and he can boom it downfield. It's a good shot. Almost. Here I'm last, so I'm just going to wait. It's two players, and I'm going to shoot this towards net. So they end up jumping on top of each other, which is a situation that we've had quite a few times, so it's obviously very common. Here, I think Gower Tower actually should have left that for his teammate, because he made I actually can't score. He says, you liar. I just noticed that. Once Gower made a touch like that, he needs to let his teammate come in and trust that he's going to make that clear. He said, liar. Oh, boy. So I grabbed that mid boost, which means my teammate... Oh, nice shot. My teammate should notice that and make a different play. So he turns immediately into the play and makes a shot. So well done. Well done by him. See, my teammate leaves that for me. He wants to go, so I'll let him go. It's good clear. I can see this is going to bounce up and out, so I want to be ready for that. Way behind. A little bit of a bump for my teammate, but I'm just going to jump off the wall and stay close. So what the opponent just did wasn't the greatest, but this could be a goal for them. Going as last man there, I could have made a better play, but once again, he's last man, just making a very risky challenge. Those are the kind of things you don't want to be doing, because you're going to put your teammate in a weird spot above him. It's a good try on the challenge. This ball is going to bounce out mid a little bit, so my teammate rotates. Bit of a miss. Oh. 50-50 though. So I'm going to support him here. Bounce in mid. Hopefully my teammate can move forward. Oh, nice try. Nice try. He's not happy about that one. Oh, we've completely lost him. He's back. All right, so here we're just going to wait for the opponent. Once in Gower Tower, this guy is making a lot of risky last man challenges. And that's the kind of thing... I'm surprised my teammate didn't... Okay, he's right behind me. I'm surprised he didn't cut in front of me there. Oh. Almost. Let my teammate rotate on this one. So he's playing passive behind me. That's fine. I'm going to loop around. So when you have a player who's also really, really passive, you just got to fill the gaps and kind of, you know, glue the ball like that and get a goal by accident. Nice. So he made a clear in the mid, and I wanted to make sure I covered that. If I don't push up on that, one of those players are going to capture that ball and make a shot. So I made sure to watch what my teammate was doing in that corner and then follow it. Kind of cringe. Oh, no. I'm not even sure I'm doing anything that crazy, honestly. Let's see what he says. Is that just going to go in? That might just go in. Let's play dumb. See, my teammate was actually plat, so, you know, it happens. Teammate has been pretty good, though. Obviously, he was frustrated with that one goal, but I'm not even doing anything that crazy. They're really just not playing well. I'm going to be honest with you. Like, there's like Gower is just throwing it mid, and there you go. So, I don't know who he's at. Oh, and he's gone. He probably thinks Hickory Ham Mike is smurfing, which is interesting because he's the one actually making like crazy shots. We're both getting good goals here. That was an interesting game. To be fair, this is Leth. He's not wrong. Oh boy. I want to see what he says. I don't even know if he knows who I am. Honestly, I don't know how many people watch me that are in these ranks, but we'll see what he says back if he says anything. Oh, I got egoed. Oh no. So honestly, I don't even know what I was doing that game to make them think I was smurfing. I mean, I made a few shots, but I don't know. Let me know in the comments if I was playing a little bit too fast for this rank. I really don't know. I felt like I was playing a little bit faster than I normally do, but we're also moving up in the ranks and people are making good defensive touches. You could see from the first game we played that people were making good touches. And I mean, I don't know. I just feel like I wasn't doing anything too crazy. And honestly, I don't know if he was even talking about me, because I just felt like my teammate was doing just as much. I kind of cut my teammate off there, but it should be okay. So make sure you use a little bit of boost there to grab that mid boost. And you can see how that actually makes me pick it up. If I'm at 100, I won't pick up that mid boost. And the opponent will get the ball. So right here, I'm just going to loop out wide. sit behind. Take a little bit of a touch. Obviously could have just scored that, but I want to make sure I don't do anything too crazy, because apparently I got revealed last game from what I was doing. Teammate didn't want to challenge, or the opponent didn't want to challenge. I'll pop this across. In these situations where the ball goes super high, you can make a shot from here if you're better, but if you're lower rank, you can kind of just pop that middle and wait for the ball to cross on the floor. Good challenge. So here I can let the ball do the work and go up the wall. I'll come in and pop the ball off the wall with a little jump, and it lets me catch the wall again after that touch too. And the reason why I jump is to make the ball pop off the wall a little bit further. This is a pretty high challenge. I don't think people in gold will go for the backboard reads. So instead what I do is just sit underneath the ball and wait for it to come in mid and try to make the best challenge I can. Good clear, good try. See what Java's got. See if you pass the middle. A little bit of a bump. That's fine. I'll let Java go again. Stay in mid here. So once again, looping wide first, then coming around the ball. And that's how I'm able to get around him, by waiting for that second touch. See, these plays are pretty good. I feel like I was not doing as much as they were. It's a pretty good shot. All I have to do is pop there. And then once again, oh, my teammate bumped me, but that's okay. It's a good shot from them. Right here, I just popped it off the backboard. Obviously, I would have made a better clear, but I don't want to be suspicious, I guess. Like, you want to loop wide and make a clear to the corner on those, but in this situation, we're just chilling. We're making good clears, making good shots. Just being reliable to our teammate. I'll loop out wide here, see if my teammate can get in there. It's a good clear, could shoot it. Take his time. It's a good save. This pop off the backboard could be dangerous for them, but he's waiting. That's fine. Okay. A little bit dicey. It's okay though. The ball pops on the wall. Here I can just wait. Make a 50-50. Loop behind. That's fine. I think my teammate wants to make it clear or something. It's good. So right here, I see my teammate in front of me. I don't want to position on top of him. We both miss. Teammate's a little bit slow to react to those chances. He tries to set it up and be like reliable, but at the same time, you have to take your chances when you have them. So here I'm going to pop this up towards the goal and see if he makes a save. Good try. So there, we just pop it up towards the goal. I have position on the ball, or possession on the ball here. I just jump up nice and early and pop it up nice and high. And Jose wasn't able to make it clear to the corner. So maybe I'm moving a little bit too fast. I have no idea. So I'm going to grab these mid boost pads as I move back behind my teammate. You see I have like about 60. It's a high pop. Pretty dangerous. Go for the bump on me and make sure to avoid that. Kind of multitasking there to avoid the bump and make the touch, but I'll stay with this. Teammate wants it now. That's fine. So make sure to touch it off the corner. See if my teammate wants to move in. Get a little bit of a bump on the opponent. Didn't even mean to. That's okay though. Oh, I thought he was going to go. A little bit of a fast recovery, but you can see one front flip and we're already all the way back on our side. Okay, well, that wasn't a rotation for my teammate there. I'm not sure what's going on. I'm gonna move around and be the bigger person once again. All right, so that touch is a little bit risky from from the opponent. Okay, this could be good for us. Nice, good finish. So they bunched up in the corner. Right there, I know that they're in a bad position. Once they're covering each other like that, once he throws it away with that flip, then I can come in and make that touch and it goes across and my teammate clears it into the goal. So I don't feel like I did anything too special there. Just made sure to watch for that opening. Okay, teammate is not coming, so I'm going to just rush this. Take this corner boost too, and then I'll move out. That's all I got to do. Okay, so here's a pretty high ball. I'm last. So is Jose, but he's a little bit closer to the position because the ball's rolling towards him, or like going towards his side. So it requires me to commit a little bit more on his half of the field than it does for him. So it makes sense that he would go for it versus me. I'll clear this out the corner here, off the wall. It's a good try by my teammate. The right idea, but you can catch that ball at the same time. Good clear. All right, so here I got some space. See, my teammate can come in and make a touch. Nice. There we go. A little bit of a kerfuffle there, but it's all good. So it was on target. I tried to stop it, and like I popped it up over that one player. A little bit advanced, but it's not too crazy. Nice little pass off. My teammate finished it off once again. Sort of carrying me. He's got two goals, but at the same time, we assisted both of those. And it looks like that guy's done because there's only like a second left of the game. And that's going to be it for this episode. So we're moving up the ranks quite quickly here, finally. Oh, we lost connection. Oh, no. Oh, no. That's rough. But yeah, we are gold 3 division 1. So we're finally into the upper ranks of gold here at the end of this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I know that I'm trying not to, you know, be too fast or play too quick. I kind of feel bad for that one guy who said I was smurfing, but I don't even know if it was me that he was talking about. But until next time, hope you guys have a great day, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.